During this procedure, surgeon should be on left side of the patient, assistant should be to the left of the surgeon, while scrub nurse and instruments are on right side of the patient, and monitor is on patient's right shoulder at the level of surgeon's eyes. Hello viewers, first we will show you different instruments which are used in laparoscopic cholecystectomy. This is laparoscope, and there are different types and angles used in this laparoscope. Different instruments have different names and different functions which are used in laparoscopic cholecystectomy. This one is laparoscope, and the next one instrument is stone extractor, which is used when there is difficult gallbladder extraction. So first gallstones are removed with this extractor, and then gallbladder is removed from 11 millimeter port. First one is scissors, and next black instrument is L-hook, that's for me L-hook, and this is gallbladder grasper. These instruments also have different lengths, and longer instruments are used in obese patient for procedure of laparoscopic cholecystectomy. This one is clip applicator, which is used for metal clips to be applied, and this is crocodile, which is used to extract gallbladder. For pneumoperitoneum, open technique is used and Hessian trocar is passed. Blunt trocar is used to insert 10 to 11 millimeter cannula as optical or camera ports. Operating pressure for pneumoperitoneum should be around 12 to 14 millimeter of mercury. Gas port is attached and pneumoperitoneum is being created and is checked by tympanic sound. Camera port is passed in supra or infra umbilical region as the indication may be. Laparoscope is then attached to the monitor. Light source is then attached to view the area in abdomen. Settings are then done, and before passing laparoscope into the abdomen, white balance is being maintained, as you can see in the monitor that white balance is okay. After passing laparoscope, second port is passed, which is 5 millimeter port in right hypochondrium region. This port is used for handling, manipulation and retraction of gallbladder. Laparoscope is used as a guide to pass this port. Another port is passed in subxiphoid region. This port is also of 10 millimeter diameter. Port site entry should be approximately 2 centimeter below xiphisternum. Incision should be of approximately 10 millimeter size and just toward right side of linea alba. This trocar should enter towards right side of falciform ligament. Then inspect whole of the abdomen to see any concomitant pathology. Divide omental or visceral adhesion and use suitable robust wretched grasper to expose Hartmann pouch and Calot's triangle. Apply retraction to Hartmann's pouch by grasper in left hand while dissecting instrument in right hand, like Maryland forceps, diathermy L hooks, scissors. Carefully dissect Calot's triangle to expose cystic duct and artery. After isolating these, about one third of proximal gallbladder should be dissected from liver to be sure of correct identity of cystic structures, so-called critical view of safety. When absolutely satisfied about anatomy of critical view of safety, metal clips are applied, two on proximal side of the cystic duct and one towards distal side. There are different sizes of cartridges of these metal clips, which are according to the size, different metal clips are used. We have ligated cystic artery and cystic duct with same metal clips, although preferably separate metal clips are used for cystic ducts and artery. Now divide cystic duct with scissors, leaving approximately 3 mm tissue of cuff towards cystic duct, and two metal clips are left behind in the abdomen over cystic duct area. Now grasp Hartmann's pouch with left hand and retract cranially to facilitate dissection of gallbladder from liver in cystic plate area. Care should be taken not to straight dissection deep into the liver bed area where middle hepatic vein lies just superficial to gallbladder bed and fossa. Before removing gallbladder fundus from liver, hemostasis is secured and small blood vessels are cauterized, or bleeding points are also cauterized. Sometime in cystic plate area, there are small blood vessels or small bile duct of Lushka. If these are encountered, these should be ligated separately and proximally. Gallbladder is placed over the liver and hemostasis is being secured. Any small bleeding points over gallbladder fossa are being cauterized. Use smaller cuff of gauze piece to mop the area, and if there is any need, we can do cauterization. In this operation, we have not placed drain in subhepatic area because there was no ooze over surgical site area. But if drain is placed, it should not be suction drain and it should be placed through 5 mm port site area. gallbladder is retrieved by grasping gallbladder with crocodile forceps and then extracting it through 10 mm port site, either from subxiphoid site or through camera port. Gallbladder is being removed from subxiphoid site. If gallbladder is difficult to come out, then Mayo scissors or artery clamps are used to extend or widen that incision site. Even we can use blade to cut skin or subcutaneous tissue to widen this incision site. Subhepatic area and gallbladder fossa is perfectly fine. There is no ooze, so there is no need to place drain. Ports are removed one by one and carefully, and gas is being released. Remove ports under direct vision and check again hemostasis or any bleeding from port site area. Zero absorbable suture is used to close facial planes of 11 mm ports and 5 mm ports. Some surgeons also prefer to close them. This action will prevent hernia formation at port site area. Close skin site area according to your own preference with non-absorbable suture. With small pieces of surgical gauze, dressing is done over wound area and then sticking is applied over these sides to end the procedure. Gallbladder is being dissected and opened up to show the type and number of stones. That's all about whole procedure of laparoscopic cholecystectomy.
Please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon so that we can send you the latest videos.